This is my experience of growing up in Cobh. Growing up in a council estate in Cobh, lived in Russell Heights for 17 years, which was probably the roughest estate in Cobh. I have two brothers and three sisters. Mother and father were together and still together today. And family life growing up was normal. No violence, alcoholism or drugs. Played a lot of different sports as a child and teenager, like GA and soccer. I was talented at sport from a young age. There would have been a lot of violence, drinking, drugs and vandalism in my estate, and growing up wasn't easy. Trying to fit in with people and impress the older people for approval. It wasn't a normal day unless there was a fight or some act of violence or vandalism. Learning to fight and look after yourself was a very important thing to do growing up, because if you were weak, you were picked on, and that's the way it always was. Smoking cigarettes at a young age to fit in was normal, and eventually I was introduced to hash, and of course traded to fit in, and that was the start of my addiction, because I couldn't get enough of it. Dropped out of school at 16 and got a job as a fabricator. Started drinking at 16, mainly only on weekends, and always smoked hash every day. And having a job, it was no problem paying for my habits. Life was good, I suppose, until I turned 18. Started hanging around with people older than me. Going out, pubbing and clubbing every Friday, Saturday and Sunday, every weekend. Got into a lot of trouble at this age. Fighting nearly every weekend, getting arrested for public order offences, drink driving and fighting. Would have tried Class A drugs such as ecstasy and cocaine, but only on the odd occasion. I left my job at 19 and returned back to school to complete my leaving cert. Drinking and taking drugs became more frequent and missed a lot of school days. Shortly before I was to sit my leaving cert, I buried one of my close friends who died due to an alcohol-related accident. I managed to scrape through my leaving cert, but slowly but surely my addiction spiralled out of control. Could not drink without compulsion to take drugs. My attitude on life was after changing, and I had no ambition in life. Did not want to work, and only done the odd course to keep the social off my back. There was nothing to do, I thought, only to drink and do drugs. A lot of people I grew up with had lost their lives due to suicide or drink and drug related deaths. At this stage, I was a complete binge drinker, and there was always drugs involved. Out for 4 days solid, come down for three and do it all again every week. I sold drugs to support my habits. I only felt normal when I was out of my head. Shortly after my 24th birthday, I hit the height of depression and had the thoughts of suicide, which scared me into thinking that there was another way. I always wanted to stop the madness, but never could, so I sought help from a friend who was in recovery. Asked him, what do I do? And I started going to meetings, AA and NA. From my first meeting, I knew I belonged. Shortly after, I was advised to Gemma Turner by my sister-in-law. Gemma helped me how to deal with my addiction, explained addiction is a disease, and it really helped me understand it. Gemma also helped me with going to Arbor House and Tabor Lodge, which were the best things I ever done. I meet with Gemma once a week and continue with meetings and aftercare. With Gemma's help, I am 6 months clean and sober today, and without Gemma's help and support, I do not think I would be sober today.